Hello everyone, today we learn about the important medicinal crop that is aloe. In Marathi it also known as korpad. It is a perennial succulent crop. Its family liliaceae. Some commercial important species of aloe vera, that is aloe vera barbadensis, aloe vera ferox, aloe vera african and aloe vera spectra. These are the important species of aloe vera crop. Then two of the major products derived from the leaves are the yellow bitter juice consisting of aloe and the gel consisting of polysaccharides. Apart from these products, several other products like dehydrated aloe powder, and these are extensively used as an active ingredient in laxative and anti-obesity preparation. As anti-obesity and preparation as a moisturizer, emollient or wound healer in various cosmetic and pharmaceutical formulations. Some the plant description of aloe vera. Aloe vera is a coarse looking perennial shallow rooted plant with a short stem 30 to 60 cm height, and the plants have multiple tuberous root and many supporting root penetrating into the soil. Aloe does not have a true stem but produce bloom stalk. Fleshy leaves are densely crowded, strongly cultivated and have a spiny margin within walled tuberous cell. The flowers vary from yellow to rich orange in color and are arranged in an axillary spice. Some important species and varieties of aloe vera. In India, two or three easily recognized varieties are found. First, Baker. It is a commerce which is common all over the Deccan. The leaves have a distinct purple color towards the base and the spaces are not sharp. Another variety which thrives on the Kathiawada coast, also called aloe vera abhisheka, is the source of the Jafarabad aloe. Aloe vera varigianata, called aloe vera varigianata, a near kin of aloe vera, is found in the part of the Maharashtra. It has large fleshy green leaves with sharp spine and white spike at the base of the leaves. The next important point, that is soil. It is a very hardy nature crop. That's why the plants can be grown in wide variety of soil. It can be seen growing successfully from sandy coastal soil to loamy soil of plain area with soil pH up to 8.5. The waterlogged condition and problematic soil do not suit for cultivation of aloe vera crop. The next, climate. It has wide adaptability and can be grown in various climatic conditions. It can be seen growing equally good in warm, humid or dry climatic condition with 150 to 200 centimeter to about 35 to 40 centimeter of rainfall per annum. Okay, then it is usually cultivated between March and June. However, in dry region, the crop should be provided with long dry spell is occur, then we give irrigation to the crop for better flesh present in or for better flesh development in their leaves and increase the yield percentage of the crop. Next important point is propagation. It is generally propagated by root suckers or rhizomes cutting. For its purpose, medium size root suckers are chosen and carefully dug out without damaging the parent plant at the base and directly planted in the main field. It can be also propagated through rhizomes cutting. In this case, after the harvest of the crop, the underground rhizome is also dug out and made it into 5 to 6 cm length cutting, which should have minimum 2 to 3 nodes on them. It is rooted in specially prepared sand beds or containers, and after it has started sprouting, it is ready for transplanting. Then planting. The field should be prepared well before the onset of monsoon and small furrows open. The root suckers or rhizomes cutting are planted at a proper spacing, that is 60 by 45 cm, in such a way that 2/3 portion of the planting material should be under the ground. The next, manuring. Application of mixture, that is 150 kg of nitrogen, phosphorus, potash is given according to the growth and according to the planting time or according to the growth of the crop. The fertilizers are applied in this near to the soil region. Then irrigation and weeding. Soon after planting, the land is irrigated during the crop period. Irrigation must be given according to the moisture status of the soil. Generally, 5 to 6 irrigation per year are sufficient for cultivation of aloe vera crop. However, water should not be allowed to stagnate near the plant, means waterlogged soil is not good for cultivation of the aloe vera. The land is kept weed free by weeding the post as well as necessary weeding. The next, pest and disease management and major pest and major diseases we see here. First, there is mealybug. It is a major disease, mealybug, and some major diseases in mealybug. That is mealybug. It is a major pest in aloe vera, and then some major diseases like leaf spot, leaf rot, and anthracnose. Control measures of these diseases, that is by spraying of chloropyrifos 2 mL per liter of water for control measures for the mealybug. Then spray the crop with bavistin 10 gram with carbendazim 2 gram per liter and respect at 10 days interval for controlling leaf rot and anthracnose. Then third, leaf spot can be controlled by spraying the crop with 0.2% mancozeb at weekly intervals. Then last important point, that is harvesting and processing. After about 8 months after transplanting in the main field, the leaves are ready for harvest. While harvesting, the plants can be recommended manually. The broken rhizomes part left in this soil through new shoot sprout to raise the succeeding crop. Aloe plantation gives commercial yield from second year and up to 5 years. Thereafter, it needs replantation for economic yield. An average crop yield of about 10,000 to 12,000 kg on fresh weight of the leaves on the basis of the obtain from the hectare. Means in 1 hectare we obtain fresh leaves, that is 10,000 to 12,000 kg. The last important point, that is processing. The mucilaginous pulp from the leaves parenchyma, which is mainly carbonated in nature, it is used in a skin disorder. For the purpose of isolation of aloe gel, the portion of leaves remaining after the removal of their exudate is cut open and their mucilages is scraped out with a blunt edges knife. This mucilage is sterile vigorously in a blender to make it into uniform solution, and it is sterile through a mucilaginous cloth and filtered. The gel is precipitated from the extract by slowing, adding acetone. The gel is obtained by centrifuging and redissolving in the slightly warm water. It is dried at high temperature and wet. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.